Hi, I'm Tim Berglund with Confluent, and in showing you the fundamentals of Apache Kafka, now I'd like to tell you all about Confluent Platform. As you're making Kafka into the central nervous system of your organization, you're adopting event streaming as a paradigm, building more and more event-driven applications, other needs arise. There are other things that you're going to need. You're going to need replication between on-prem and cloud or between regions in cloud. You're going to need automatic balancing of data within a Kafka cluster. You're going to need enterprise-grade security. You're going to need management and monitoring. All these kinds of things are what Confluent Platform gives you. And as you, as an organization, as a developer, mature in your use of event streaming, you start at learning Kafka, then you go to production, and then you find some application that really works, and you scale it, and then you start looking, well, there's these silos in the organization. This worked well for us. Another part of the organization does the same thing, and you get connectivity of that data through Kafka between silos. And then really the kind of the apotheosis of this is getting to a streaming first paradigm throughout the entire enterprise. As you move up that scale, Kafka is exactly where you need to start. Kafka is the center of this system all along, but you're going to need more, and Confluent Platform helps you complete that journey. And just as Kafka is adopted across all kinds of verticals, so is Confluent Platform. You've got banking, financial services, retail, healthcare, travel, telecom, automotive, transportation, all kinds of industries have these same needs when they go to production and mature with their use of Kafka. Confluent Platform really adds a lot of value in those cases. And let's just look sort of at a layered diagram of what's in the platform. We have, of course, Apache Kafka as the foundation. That's that bottom there. And then you've got Kafka Connect connectors in that next layer, labeled development and connectivity. There are a number of connectors that come with Confluent Platform that aren't available outside of Confluent Platform. KSQL DB is, of course, available for free. You don't need to be a Confluent Platform subscriber to use that, but proper platform support for KSQL DB is there as well. And then enterprise operations. You've got Confluent Replicator for operating clusters between data centers or between cloud regions. Auto Data Balancer to keep partition data balanced between brokers. And the Kubernetes operator, which is an absolutely huge thing. If you want to run your own deployment, you don't want to run in Confluent Cloud, you want to run Confluent Platform, but you want to run in Kubernetes, we've got a custom operator that makes all these elements of the platform run natively and properly in Kubernetes without you having to build all that functionality yourself. And of course, you've got management monitoring through Control Center and enterprise-grade security as well. And mind you, Confluent Platform is not particularly opinionated whether you run it in a public cloud or on your own infrastructure. Some of us kind of have this cloud-first conceit where we think, well, everything's in the cloud. How could I possibly deploy a data center of my own? But there are some organizations for real either financial or regulatory or data sovereignty reasons do have to operate their own infrastructure. And in those cases, running Confluent Platform on machines in your own data center is a first-class thing to do. If you also want to run it in public cloud or exclusively in public cloud, that works fine. You could have a cluster in the cloud, a cluster in your data center, keeping those up to date through Replicator. That is all supported activity with great examples online of how to get that done. Of course, apart from all that talk of you deploying the platform, whether on instances in the cloud or hardware of your own, is one thing. The other major way to get this done is Confluent Cloud. Confluent Cloud is a fully managed Kafka service with, at the time of this recording, many of the elements of Confluent Platform available themselves as fully managed services in Confluent Cloud. And of course, it's available on the main public clouds, Amazon, Google, and Azure. When you create a new cluster in Confluent Cloud, you identify the cloud provider you want to host that cluster, and everything is taken care of for you. Confluent Control Center is a very important user interface that's a part of Confluent Platform. It is the web-based management and monitoring tool for Confluent Platform. Really a purpose-built system to show you what's going on in your cluster, and not just what's going on in Kafka, but all of the other elements of the platform as well. So what are your ksql db applications doing? What are your connectors doing? Is there something with mqtt proxy? All these things, we can visualize what's happening and configure them through Control Center. Confluent CLI is just what it sounds like. It's a command line tool that allows you to manage your Confluent platform or Confluent Cloud deployment. And there are some things at the time of this recording that you need to use the CLI for, like RBAC, role-based access control. Configuring that is a thing that's done through the CLI. And many of us, we just kind of prefer this. So it's nice that this is here as a tool to supplement Control Center. So we can script things, we can do things in the terminal, where some of us are just more comfortable. I mentioned RBAC, role-based access control. This is a new set of security features that's been around in Confluent Platform for a little while, as of 5.3, which was in kind of the middle of 2019 as a preview. And what this basically does is, if you've got a large organization with a large number of principals, say there's different applications who are going to authenticate themselves to the Kafka cluster and say, I'm application XYZ, and I should have the ability to read these five topics and write these two topics. And that's all I should see, right? And then application ABC needs to be able to read this one topic and write this other topic. And that's like all that it can do. Well, if there's a lot of ABCs and XYZs in your world, if that gets up into the dozens, then those get difficult to manage one by one, to have access control lists for all the individual principals. Probably they fall into groups, right? There are what we call roles that those applications can take. There's probably a smaller number of roles that we group those many individual users, kind of virtual users, application names, but we group those users into those roles and then assign privileges to roles. And so those applications can authenticate themselves as a role, and based on that role, they'll get access to what they should have access to. So really just a way of grouping things together and managing security on the basis of those group names rather than on all the individual things. So it's supported across the platform, ksql, connect, schema registry, Kafka itself, all those things. You have role-based access control to whatever it is you can authorize in each one of those components. You can do it through a role. I mentioned the Confluent operator a moment ago. If you are deploying Confluent Platform in Kubernetes, as an increasing number of people are doing, if you're not using cloud, you are more and more likely to be running in Kubernetes. And this is absolutely essential. There are other Kafka operators out available in the world, but the Confluent operator is one that is an outstanding Kafka operator and also supports all the other elements of the Confluent platform. So if you want to have a one ksql db cluster of three nodes and another of five and have Kubernetes manage those, well, the Confluent operator will help you do that. If you've got Kafka Connect and you want to manage that, of course, we're there for you. And of course, Confluent operator supports all the other components of the platform, whether you're running in the cloud or on-prem. Doesn't matter. You can use Kubernetes and Confluent Platform together. One of the big things that this does is manage persistent volumes, since all these services are stateful, right? Particularly Kafka brokers are stateful, and ksql db servers are stateful. So managing those persistent volumes is a big thing. If you know a little bit about Kubernetes, that's not trivial out of the box. And so operator gets that done for you. Also supports security integration, automatic rolling upgrades, automatic rolling updates of configuration, elastic scaling of Kafka and other CP components. So all the stuff that you'd expect Kubernetes to do, it now does. Confluent Platform also includes a large number of supported connectors. Now, as I've said, there's hundreds of connectors out there in the world, many of them on GitHub and available as open source things, which is, of course, beautiful. But sometimes if there's a connector you find for kind of a more unusual data source, right? Maybe there's not a gigantic community around that, but you need it. And like the last commit was 2.5 years ago, and it doesn't seem to be very busy. I mean, there's open source. Years ago in open source, we used to talk about the distinction between free as in beer and free as in speech. Sometimes some of these connectors are free as in puppy, right? Like you don't have to pay for it, but you're going to give it a lot of care and feeding when it comes home. So the broader connector ecosystem in Confluent Platform is a good thing. These are developed by Confluent, supported by Confluent, and they should cover a lot of your bases. Once you get to 100 or so connectors, you've really covered a substantial proportion of the kinds of integration tasks that you might encounter, and you're doing it in a supported way. Those connectors and others, by the way, are available on Confluent Hub. That's hub.confluent.io. This is our curated set of all the connectors that we know about and can bring ourselves to put on the website. These are not all open source, and they're not all commercial. License is specified for each one. So, you know, you'll be able to see if this is like some completely Apache or MIT licensed thing, or is it Confluent Community licensed, or is it a proprietary Oracle connector, or whatever. They're all there. And this is a handy way to search for them and be able to download them and install them into Connect. So with that, you've got a good overview of Confluent Platform, and really you should think of Confluent Platform as an essential part of driving Kafka into the business. You can adopt Kafka as an open source thing. You could build streaming applications on top of it. You could use KSQL DB and Schema Registry and their free versions, and you could do all that. But once money is on the table and this becomes a strategic part of the business, often the business wants, as they move up that maturity model, a supported and official thing with the kinds of features that emerge as these applications become more business critical. You find those in Confluent Platform. So you'll probably find this useful as your adoption of Kafka moves up the scale.